And we're back. Pre-recorded. This is Sean. What's going on? In my last video, I was listening to this life coach talk about how to fix issues with your roleplay games. How to solve player problems and things without saying how to fix player problems. Anyway, don't even watch his video. Don't watch the last video. Just watch this one. Over here, I was just picking random spots and they were at a door. They didn't know how to open a door. And he says, the door is made of planks. It's just a plank door. And they still were like, how do we open it then? Do we know how to open plank doors? So they have the door problem in this video. So be prepared for that if we see it. Okay. I don't want to hear music. Everyone has to have one of these intros. Why? Just start the game. Community game? That sounds gay. Okay, this is session 10. So these players, I'm assuming these are the same players that were in session 0. Maybe someone's fallen out of the game since then. After 10 sessions, you should know how to play a game without asking the GM any questions, right? You should just be able to role play your character at this point. Let's find out. And they're using a VTT. That sucks.
Night fell and you guys fought through and struggled through this curse with Gabriel's guidance. You guys were able to overcome and survive a night with this curse on you. As the night fell, though, if you remember, the island that it sits in the middle of Merovingia had a beam of swirling light reach up from it into the heavens. Yeah. So that's where we're picking up as you guys. We're going to say the time hasn't gotten, like, you didn't have to take a full long rest in terms of story timing. You'll get the benefits of the long rest. You've leveled up to level 7 now. So you've gone through quite a bit. If you want to stop and actually take the whole night, you're welcome to do that. But you can also just continue on the story if you prefer to do that. So what do you guys want to do?
I'd say if we've got the benefits of a full rest already, we'd probably just get up and get going. That's what Fisker would do. He's ready to go.
The players talk in terms that the game uses. This is what your character can do during your turn. Pick one. Well, I guess if I rested enough, I guess I'm getting up then. How about my character gets up out of the bed, stretches, looks for something to eat, stomach growls, you know, something like that.
All right.
Yeah, Valshai is ready to just charge in there.
Gabriel only needs 3 minutes to write down something on 3 parchments.
Okay. You do that.
Yeah, and after write that, he's going to give both you, Velsi, and you, Vashtai, one of them, and say, in case I die, this is my will. Don't read it before I die. And the first paragraph is for you. This is just for good measures, so my word gets to the ones it needs to get to. I ain't taking...
Okay, so this Gabriel wants to tell a story of his own. For the other players, that's fine, I suppose.
Risks.
Well, I'll do everything I can to keep you alive, sir. Don't you worry about it.
Same.
And with that, how do you guys want to proceed?
What do you do? Well, they see this one little area here. So, if they're looking at this map that I'm seeing, they're gonna fiddle fart around in this area until he zooms out and they'll go, hey, let's go to the edge of the earth. I see the edge of the earth. Let's go there. Let's do that. But the scope right now is this area. So we'll see. We'll see what how they can role play in this area. God, I hate using maps. Because then the players focus on the map. If they see the map, they're just going to focus on it and just do what the map shows they can do. Am I close enough to where, you know, that nonsense? I don't know. Even when they're on a map.
This is the ultimate question.
What do you do?
Do we go through the teleportation circle and jump right in the middle of whatever the hell they're doing? Or do we approach from ship and try to... I would say the fastest way is the teleportation circle.
The fastest way is the teleportation circle. And if we get with the teleportation circle, that would probably raise some alarm, since we're not quite stealthy, as we could see from the
camera. Yeah, no.
So my plan is to send some of the Augury members with the ship towards there. So if either of us get noticed, either the Augury members or we, one of us is going to cause a distraction. So either we get an advantage, or they get an advantage.
Hey, DM, do we know how long it would be for a ship to reach the island?
I hate these kinds of questions. What difference does it make? Why are you asking that? Why aren't you role-playing?
This ship, at this time, it would take it a good... 2 hours, probably.
2 hours.
Sail out there.
Yeah. Okay, so that plan goes to water, literally.
Yeah, that's not bad. 2 hours is not bad. I was thinking longer than that. It would take longer, but no, that's not terrible.
I mean, it's big, but there's enough wind in this area that, you know, ships move pretty quickly through here.
I think it's a better idea for someone to stay around the teleportation circle when we leave if someone tries to escape through it back.
I'm not sure what this is called. They're kind of in character, but they're kind of also strategizing. You know, it's a board game. This is a board game to them. Let's see. Do they ever... Okay, now they're at the boat. Let's see. How do they get to the boat? Do they go there, or does the GM just say, now you're on the boat? Okay, so now you guys have traveled to the boat. Here we go.
For a few moments, you see a rowboat comes to shore, picks you up, and takes you back out to the ship.
Okay, so the GM just says, now you're at the boat. You didn't have to do anything. No one said anything about, I get on the rowboat. No, they're just magically taken there. Hand of God stuff.
Where you have...
Step on God's hand. It will take you to where you need to go.
This is still working. Hey.
Bring up the other map. Explain to us that you're figuring out how to bring up the map. Do it.
The dead guy is still on the ship. No, you guys did dump him off.
We dumped him.
Cool.
And Alexandris was also dumped, so. But you guys board the ship, and you are making your way now to this island. Is there anything you want to do on the ship in preparation as you...
What? Hang on. The ship's already on course to this place? Where's the crew? Who did the thing? Who said the thing? God, it's a magical ship. It's already going where they needed to go. What a coincidence. What if the players decided to do something else? Would this picture even get used? Does he have other places they could have gone to that day? It's all according to my plan. So the GM has players that he can just lead around by the nose in his game. That's unfortunate.
You approach. You know, as you get closer to the island, I'll describe this part for you. You notice that there is actually a pretty tall spire of a mountain in the middle of it.
Show a picture. Show a picture of the island. That's more interesting than staring at a boat deck.
Where it seems that this light is coming from. And one of the sailors, Grosh, informs you that in their recon, sailing around the area for a while, they did find a keep on one side of the island that had a dock at it that looks like it was...
Fuck! Info dump. Tell the players what they're going to find before they get there. I have this island idea in my head. Let me have one of my NPCs tell you how awesome this island is that you're going to be going to soon.
Might be inhabited, but they didn't see anyone coming in or out of the keep in the time that you guys were there, or that they had the chance to see.
Well, if anything lives there, if it's hostile, it's going to be dead. If it's not, well, we have allies.
Yeah, I think that might be our safest bet, because trying to land a ship anywhere where there isn't a cove or a docking, like a pre-made
dock. It's basically destruction of our ship.
Yeah, just basically crashing the ship into the side of an island.
That would be kind of funny. Okay, so you guys are going to head to the keep then, is the order you give.
Yeah.
At this point, you still have maybe half an hour left before you're going to arrive. In the distance, you can see the island and this keep. It's only about two stories tall, this building, but it's made up of stone walls on the outside, and you see there's a small dock on the front. And there is actually some smoke coming out of one of the chimneys. You guys are able to see it from this distance even. It kind of goes up and blends in to the light that's coming out of the mountain on this island.
Let's go to when they hop off the boat. A boat? Does Stevie say anything in this game? I've seen this person before. I've seen this person before. I don't remember any of these three being outspoken role players. Okay, so it looks like they hop. Pichu.
Too soon. Too excited for this fight. Well, let's take the rowboat and go ashore.
See, they're strategizing. Why can't they just roleplay what their character would do? Sinbad, in the Sinbad movies, he just gets into a rowboat. He's got his hired staff rowing the boat for him. He just kind of stands there and looks heroic. He doesn't know what to expect at some island he's going to. These guys already seem to know what's on the table inside a kitchen inside of a house on an island. They haven't even been to yet. It's bizarre.
All right.
And let's just hope there it really isn't a wizard chill in there.
All right.
It's going to be a fun thing if he is.
I just noticed there's a human back here. What's that? When did that happen? Don't have humans behind you when you're roleplaying.
Hope we don't get fireballed again.
That's a fair hope. As you guys paddle in to this, I would imagine one of the augury members goes with you to help kind of paddle, so you guys don't have to worry about that too much. But he pulls you right up alongside this dock. The keep itself is 20 feet tall. You can see the tower that Ace had been talking about stands a little...
Enough with the tower. Show us a picture already. What's this top-down view crap of a dock? I don't understand. What I'm describing, I don't have a thing for. You just have to trust me on this. I've mentioned the spire thing a few times already. It's kind of a big deal. You probably should go up the thing.
A little bit higher than the others. It goes up to about 30 feet tall. A small circular kind of stone structure. From this area...
They see this from their boat. Really? Okay. Interesting.
You can see there are several windows in this that this building has. Glass windows that were in place.
Damn it.
Some of them, in some areas, those glass have been broken. You see...
Okay, so somebody... What did they do? They're sneaking around in the water? I don't know whose character is whose. What they should do is whatever these pictures are, should put a little picture in the corner of each screen here so you know who's who.
He heads up first over to the tower and looking in through the windows, you see what he's talking about, the different the books, the kind of library that's set up. Definitely an office kind of area has been set up.
Holy crap, he sees that, or she or whoever that is, sees that through windows? Really? Stained glass windows, I'm guessing? What? Whoever's in there could probably see you.
Here, he continues circling around. You don't see any other...
Is he moving their piece around? That's sacrilegious, right there.
Other windows for a little bit. They're coming through just solid stone doors. You see a back door or a side door that looks like a small stairwell leading up further into the keep with a small door.
They know what this building looks like from outside, right? It's tall and nonsense and all that stuff, but... Me being a role player, I would just go in through the front entrance. See what happens. What's the worst that could happen? You get killed? Fine. We die. We die together.
Continuing around further, more stone walls, and then he gets to the front. Where you are able to see there is a big double doors on the front of this keep. There's some stairs going up into it. Just a standard kind of...
Info dumping, kind of, sort of. Meanwhile, these players aren't saying a goddamn thing. When they get to a door, are they able to walk into it? Are they going to ask questions? I think this is when they ask questions about the door. Can we go through the door? Oh, I can't walk.
Standard keep. The interesting...
This is painful to watch. For most people at home, they're probably thinking, Driscoll, what is wrong with this? There's nothing wrong with this game session. This is what they do.
One thing you notice, though, about this, Gabriel, is it has a similar symbol on the door to the amulet that Velsir had picked up.
Wow, just more info dump. That means something to Gabriel's character, I'm guessing?
Of the... A ruined tower underneath some rays of something. Continuing his loop, Ace finds a section where the walls, instead of a stone wall, it's kind of a wooden pillars have...
Where's the part where two guards see him and then it becomes dun 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 and then you have combat. Doo, doo, doo. He's fighting these two guards by himself. And then he gets turned into a skeleton avatar because he's just been dead and picked over and left for dead on the street. That'd be kind of cool if that happened. But it's not.
I've been built up as the walls, which looks like a more of an outdoor area. And he continues his pathway around. It's a little awkward for me because I can have to keep an eye on everything you can see. You do find another room that has some windows open, and kind of hovering around and keeping an eye on that for a moment. It looks like just a small little bedroom on the side of the building. Again, more traveling around. You see the...
Man, he's got a clear view through all these windows. Wow. It's amazing. Just from standing that far away from the window, he can see all that stuff. Wow. No glare. No dark shadows inside the rooms. Nothing. Just... Wow.
Room that's immediately up and to the left looks like a kind of a master suite where someone more important might live, as there's a pretty nice rug. But in all this circling, as he returns to you,
this would be a servant kind of a thing here. You don't put the master bedroom right next to the ugly ass dock. Oh well.
And you've seen everything that he could see. You didn't see anybody.
What is the closest window?
The closest window, period, is this one.
So he's going to ask, are we going in stealthily or are we going a little bit louder?
I was suggesting that we would probably try to...
Why is he asking what's the closest window? Why can't he just say, I'm going to go in through the window. I'm going to go in through the closest window. Something like that. But they always do it this way. They always say, okay, is there a window? Okay, there's a window. Okay, now what do we want to do? What should we all decide to do? Because Gabriel wants to be the guy doing his thing. He wants... These two are kind of like just... I'll tag along. Gabriel's actually like... You know, he wants to do all the things in the game. Because the story's really about him, probably.
Get in through the door. This back door over here. Are either of you proficient in picking locks?
I am not, but I'm good with my fingers. Flipping through pages.
In a movie, do you ever see a character say to another character, who's good at picking locks?
Has its perks.
I mean, I'm proficient in kicking in doors. But,
yeah, I would say I'm the same too, but that would be pretty loud.
That would be all guns blazing.
I think we should be a little bit...
He said he didn't see anybody. I'm assuming the GM's being honest. He's not being an unreliable narrator. I mean, me? I'm an unreliable narrator. On purpose. But I don't know. I don't know if Richard here is an honest GM.
But, you know, more stealth here.
Let's go up and see if the door is locked. It might be unlocked.
That would be quite funny. do all this trouble and the door is unlocked the whole time.
I do enjoy doing that to people. And just being like, oh no, it's unlocked. You just wasted all that time. But as you kind of expected, as you guys head up the stairs, these steps are stone. They look like they've been cleaned within the last couple days, so that it's not abandoned feeling as you guys walk up. That's something you would notice about it, especially, you know, being sneaky and trying to get a view of this place. But the door, of course, is locked.
This looks more like an office kind of thing. Remember in Morrowind, you came off the boat, you walked on the dock, and you had walked through this one place before you get to the forded area? That's what this is. And that guy would stand there and he says, what's your name? What business do you have here in Morrowind?
With your trying the door, you notice that it's really not a heavy door. It's a simple wooden plank.
Okay, here we go. You've got a door issue right here. Three players, they're going to solve this problem, how to get through a door. Let's do it. How long is it? In my games, I used to have this issue, because I had players that had this issue, and I was an inexperienced GM at the time. So I didn't know. I didn't know how to explain doors to people yet. Everyone goes through this. Everyone does. It's a rite of passage for people that run games. Players, I don't think they learn from this door thing. It's more of a GM thing. GMs learn about the door. Players will treat doors the same way all the time. It's just an enigma. Doors are a thing they just players characters just don't understand. In the world they're in, it's like, well, we're stuck now. That's the character's approach to doors. Anyway, let's see how experienced this guy is about getting players to open a door
that has been set up.
Does anybody want to try and pick the lock?
I don't have any picking tools.
Or we can do this the easy way.
Eldritch Blast.
I was thinking just using my foot and just kicking the door in.
Well, we could back up a little bit if there's a trap in front of the door.
All right, that's fine.
Why would there be a trap in front of the
door? Okay, so you're going to back up. Is that the plan? You're going to step back and let Eldritch Blast do it?
Okay. Yeah.
All right. So you guys fall back a little bit. Gabriel, are you kind of in the front then?
In the front of what?
Oh, I lost you.
Oh. how far can I move back to still have an angle in shooting the door?
It's got squares. Don't these guys see the map? I see the map. It's got 5-foot squares. Ay, ay, ay. Even with the map, no one knows where they're at, apparently.
If they move around the corner of the stairs that you guys are at, you could get back. I think that's about 15 feet like from the door. Yeah, so it's about 3 squares. You could get there. Where Vashti is standing right now.
Hey, what's with the arrow? He saw nobody. He could read parchment on the desks, but he saw nobody. There's nobody. Are they going to spawn guards there all of a sudden? What's going to happen?
Yeah.
Okay.
So kick the door in.
I'm going to move right there with Vashti, and I'm going to say, knock, knock. It's Eldritch Blast.
Okay, you're going to roll to hit.
Yes.
Yes.
I thought someone was going to kick the door in. Now he's going to... This Gabriel wants to be the center of attention, apparently. So he's going to shoot the door with explosive arrows or something?
I should be terribly disappointed. I'm not.
Did any of them turn the knob or pull the lever or do the thing first to see if the doors will open? I mean, most of the time it'll be locked, but did anyone even at least try that?
24 for the first one.
I would say, yeah, well.
Yeah.
First one?
And that 20 for the second one.
All right.
I would say that would do it.
The first crit I do is against the door.
Yeah.
Very pleasing. Like,
the perfect use of that crit.
Okay, so stop laughing and tell us what happens. It's just a door. Okay, the door is an NPC now?
The garbage rolls last session.
Yeah.
So that should be one.
Does the GM even know what's on the other side of the door? Can he quickly come up with who would be in that room at a moment's notice? With a little backstory even? I could.
+3 +3 from another bold, plus additional 9 since I add my charisma.
You had your turn. What the fuck are you doing now? What is this person doing, if anything? Just here for the ride? Just here for the lulls? This guy comes up with some ideas, apparently. I liked his idea of just kicking the door in. But no, this guy has weapons he wants to use on something.
Not to each other to blast, so... 16 damage.
Okay, well, then Gabriel, I'm going to let you narrate what this looks like, opening the door with an Eldritch Blast.
As the first blast knocks the pins that hold it, and the second one just blasts, it's flying.
So not quiet at all, you just, boom, knock this door off its hinges, basically.
Knock, knock.
The door is open. It's wide open.
There is no door left.
In front of you that looked like that leads to the tower and the hallway down to the left.
Should we
16 damage.
Okay. Boom, knock this door off stop at the door, you take a look around. It's not, there's no traps that you can see, but what you do see is just inside the door to the right, there's a...
Oh, I thought the door was here. The door's here? Okay. God, this map is crap. So one of them's missing. What happened to one of them?
Small stairway that leads up and heads up into some... It goes up to a double door. It looks like it might lead into that tower that you had seen out front. There's a long, narrow hallway, only about 5 feet wide, stretching out in front of you.
This is the other thing that happens. The door opens, but no one wants to go through the door? They stand at the doorway for how long now? How long do they stand at that fucking doorway? Two minutes? Okay, they're finally somewhere else. They're in a bedroom.
See how well I did.
All right.
12.
A lot better.
12. Vashti, do you want to investigate too?
Sure.
Me three.
All right, go ahead.
Let's all do it.
This is going to be more like a group investigation.
So much better.
I got a 10.
A 10, okay.
In total.
Okay. So kind of average. You guys
So this is just run-of-the-mill D&D nonsense. Anything exciting happen? They're playing Clue at this point. Again, they're standing at the door.
Vish, not the vicious mockery, Jesus Christ.
Just insult the deck away.
Here's somebody.
Insult the metal.
Your swings are stupid.
You're going to say cutting words, Gabriel?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead and roll that.
Yeah, 20 is exactly my armor class.
Okay,
so.
3. I got a 3. Thank God.
What is this?
Another one.
All right. What do you say, Gabriel? What is your cutting words? What you see inside is this guy. He's as tall as Velsir is, just a massive dude wearing pretty nice shining armor. On his chest is this amulet, Velsir. You recognize this. He's a shattered tower amulet. Except this one, the guy's broken it in half, it looks like. And he's holding in one...
He has time to notice all that? Okay.
In one hand, he has this flaming longsword, and the other, he's holding a shield. Gabriel, what do you say? What is your cutting words to this guy? Oh, also, he's an Asimar.
I thought Asimars were nice. Why are you such an asshole?
Straightforward, to the point. Yeah.
If I see this symbol that's been smashed in half on his person, I'm going to try and hold up my symbol and see if he recognizes who I am just from my affiliation. And if he continues being...
I like these if-then statements. Don't you just love them when they're used by players? If my character sees the thing, then I'm going to do the thing. That's my action. It's kind of like an automatic thing. Players will often say things like, while we're in this castle, if my character ever sees or notices such a thing, then I'm going to grab it and add it to my collection of histories about my family, you know, stuff like that. It's like an automatic thing that they're going to be doing. That turn is not such a thing in my games. At the moment, right now, what are you doing? I don't want to hear in the future, if my character encounters so-and-so, such-and-such, then no.
Being aggressive. If not...
Let's have everyone roll initiative.
That's a
good idea. We'll play it out as this goes.
Oh no, are they going to do combat now? Attack! I attack! Any more attacks? They're not really die rolling, are they? Oh, actually, they're... Well, I guess they did initiatives. They did their things. Whatever. Not everyone's using the thing. I guess they're rolling real dice. They're still at the doorway, for God's sakes.
Alright.
This is almost an hour later. No, this is like half an hour later almost. They're still at the door.
We'll go ahead and roll attacks. Let's see.
Alright.
Do I stick?
See what you're doing. Don't just say I roll attack.
Oh.
Oof.
No. Well, he's a
thief, hellish so. Rebuke?
It is okay. Hellish rebuke, yeah. Alright.
Yeah.
I was starting to like some of this game session until it all ended up being combat at this one doorway here. No one wants to go into the room and just say, enough! Enough with the fight! Stop! Stop it! We're here to rescue you. You know, something like that. Nope. The players think that, well, a fight started, so we have to kill everything then. We just have to fight till everything's dead. There's no way out of it.
Okay.
Actually, I'm going to step in. I'm going to move the hunter's mark over to the flaming werewolf there.
Okay.
We don't know the name of yet. So
flaming werewolf?
Gabriel, seeing this, you realize that this Genasi werewolf is the alpha and has been
not
running
for long.
Things.
See? So I'm going to have a...
I like how he just... The GM guy just says things like that. Like, oh, by the way, you notice that this NPC has, you know... Because I have this story I'm trying to tell you guys, and I want you to know something about these characters. If you're going to kill them, I'm just going to say, hey, you know, this is what they were about. Just so you knew, in case you were wondering.
Enter the room and hang off.
Who's ya?
The wall, the half-rounded wall, the quarter of a...
Ay, ay, ay. Oh, what happened? They all disappeared? What happened? Something happened.
Anything
no.
For him to do, so no.
Okay. With that, the other palace...
Oh, no, he just moved in. Okay, I'm more interested in what's going on in this area.
The twin, seeing you guys kind of flood in, he's going to just close ranks with...
Then pass out my longsword up to our dear friend that's been held.
Has anyone died yet?
Give your longsword to her?
Yes.
You guys.
Okay.
Just
and
like
you're
going
to move over there, right?
Okay, hang on. You guys have been fighting in that room. Yeah, half an hour, I guess. Half an hour you guys have been fighting in that doorway for some reason.
Yeah.
Okay. In a movie, let's say a movie has a fight scene that happens in a doorway. How long does that fight scene go for in the movie? Half an hour? 2 hour movie? And you got half an hour of the movie is just them fighting in a doorway? Hiding behind crates and doorways and things? Barrels? Pew, pew! You know, 30 minutes of that, huh? Okay.
So do you take the moment to undo her bindings?
Don't give the players ideas. Let the players roleplay. You just sit there. You just sit there, GM. Be quiet. Just sit there. Be quiet. All you have to do is say how difficult something would be to do. That's it. That's all you have to fucking say. How difficult something is. Ooh. 45 minutes almost of this nonsense. So now if something has come through a door, who knows?
History?
It doesn't
yeah.
matter.
Okay.
This will just be flat damage. Oh, plus D. Is that, does that thing have Hunter's Mark on it? Or?
No.
Strike first. Ooh, 23.
Finger. at the guy.
Come on, and, you got like...
Gonna blast and hex.
You got 3 minutes left to solve the mystery.
You're gonna hex him?
5.
Okay.
And that's the advantage one, and the next
2 minutes left.
Yeah.
That's a 10.
What are you guys doing exactly? Right. For almost an hour. For almost an hour, you've been at the...
But you're 25. It's not a surprise that, like, oh, we have a lycanthrope in the party. No, they planned it. They knew.
They knew who they were getting.
And I was afraid that they would find out. I was...
So it looks like this guy died, that guy died, the wolf died. Is this who they're rescuing, I'm guessing? It took an hour to do that. In Star Wars, Luke Skywalker shows up and he says, I'm Luke Skywalker, I'm here to rescue you. I'm here with Obi-Wan. And she's like, oh, what the fuck? Let's get going. And they have a pew-pew scene before that. They have a few pew-pew scenes after that. And then later on, they wander down a hallway and they're standing around watching Obi-Wan fight Darth Vader. That was kind of a cool scene. They're getting ready to run into the Millennium Falcon, and then you see the stormtroopers not running towards Han and everyone else. They're running towards the fight. They're like, fight, fight. They're all standing around the Millennium Falcon until they see the fight start with Darth Vader, and they're like, oh, let's go watch the fight. That was a cool thing that happened. Yeah, that's very Errol Flynn-ish when you see the guards just stop standing on duty, you know, standing at their posts and go watch, you know, King Arthur or somebody duke it out with someone, you know, hey, there's a fight, let's go watch. And they all leave their posts. I'm sure that happens in real life, right? It looks cool in a movie when it happens. It's like, William Bruce, he's fighting. He's going to go fight the king. Let's go watch.
I was afraid they would find out. How dare you keep secrets from me? How dare you?
We're the augury. We keep secrets from everybody.
Reasonable.
They keep documents.
But how dare you?
She runs out and right across the hallway.
Does anybody need any healing or anything? Or am I the only one that got hit?
Okay, so this game session, it has its flaws. All kinds of flaws. But do I like it better than Bruce Lombardo's game session? That went on for like 8 hours? Yeah. It's kind of quickish. There wasn't a whole lot of dead air space where nothing's being said.
I'm good.
Yeah, okay. No one else has gotten hit. Whoops. So I'm going to move you guys out into the hallway here real quick. Wanda leads you out, and literally right across the hallway from where you guys were, she's pushing on the wall, and there's a secret door here. And the secret door leads down some steps, and the steps go down one...
Just do it. Do it. Don't use a map next time. Just say what's happening. Don't play Parcheesi. Stop doing that.
One flight and they double back, and it looks like they triple back, and it just descends down into the darkness. And she turns and she says, are you ready?
Okay. Well, so the RPG Daily is like is same as anything else. No different. No different than what I see on the YouTubes.